Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh. Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah rabbil alamin wassalatu wassalamu ala asyrafil anbiya wal mursalin wa ala alihi washabbi ajmain. Alhamdulillah, in the previous video I have explained to you of the psychology of khushu and how it is related to flow. Today I'm going to bring this idea a bit further for us to explain the psychology of flow, khushu, fana and baka. Because within the metaphysics of Islam, there's a lot of discussion through our great scholars of the past. For more than 1,000 years, they have been explaining and detailing the state, the concept of fana and baka. Here, I'm not trying to dispute all the great scholars of Islam, whether it's Maulana Rumi or whether it is we have this Said Abdul Qadir Al-Jalani and all the other great, may Allah be pleased with them. But I'm going to give you this integration of how we can see this state from the perspective of psychology, based on modern neurological and psychological research. So this is where we, as I say, there's not a lot of discussion, that I'm just giving an idea. I hope that this can be triggering some interest of some of our neurologists, our psychologists, of how this state of flow can be achieved within the understanding of the Islamic concept of khushu, fana and baka. All right, when we understand from the traditional metaphysics of Islam, we know that we talk about the concept of fana or concept of khushu. Khushu is that you are lost in your prayer, in your worship, in your remembrance of Allah, that you focus and focus, and that focus comes about to such an extent that you feel good, you feel peaceful, you feel calm, and you feel that your worship is sincere to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. At the level of fana, you tend to lose yourself. That's why in the literatures of metaphysics of Islam, when somebody goes into the state of fana, they have tremendous ecstasy, joy, tremendous joy of the love, the mercy, the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that they begin to lose themselves, immersed in this, whether it's their zikrullah or their remembrance of Allah or their tazakkur or tafakkur, all right? And they abide in that level at a higher and higher level. So there are many levels of fana, all right? So then when they return back to their understanding of the nature of this world, then they go into baka. Baka in the sense that they always constantly sense the joy, the happiness, the ecstasy of the state of fana, that even in their normal life, they are always constantly reliving that experience to realize the grandeur of Allah, the mercy of Allah, the love of Allah, especially the love of Allah. So those who have gone through these phases of spiritual development, khushu, fana and baqa, would then be able to explain this nature of the grandeur of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His love for us to such an extent that we are, some of the scholars, some of the great teachers saying that we are lost in the ocean of the love of Allah. The ocean of love of Allah is immense, all right? But how then we relate this back to flow psychology and neurology? All right, I've explained to you in the previous video that we have, when we are normally living a life, we are living on the fight or flight or stressful life, we have this struggle state. And we are operating, our brainwave is at a beta brainwave. So we have cortisol, norepinephrine, and we are struggling. This is the usual state of displeasure, usual state of frustration, anguish. Then we go to the second level, that is release, where we have the alpha brainwave, all right? And then we go into the state of flow, where theta, gamma, and our brainwave, and we have dopamine, endorphin, and adenamine as a basic neurological chemicals that is flowing in our brain. And then we go to serotonin, where is the recovery phase, and we go to delta brainwave. So these are all research based. So when we know this is a state of flow, the state of flow can describe also the state of khushu. Because when they say you reach this state of flow, you reach a level of loss of your self-awareness in the greater scheme of things. That means people who meditate and then they realize the grandeur of what they are meditating. Okay, for example, the grandeur of, they say, nature, the grandeur of the cosmos, or they have this feeling of the state of love, So they have that. So how are we going to then explain this from the perspective of Islamic psychology? I am proposing that we understand that in Islam we have the four realms of existence: our ruh, the spirit; our qalb, that is our emotional heart; and our mind, all right, al-akal, and this is split into two: al-akal al-kulli and al-akal al-juzi. And then we have our jasad. So this SEMP must be coherent. It must be all moving towards a coherent state. This coherent state that we can then sense this whole idea of khushu, fana and baka. I'm saying this at the lower level of fana and baka. I'm not saying at the high level spiritual intensity of our great masters, our great scholars, our great teachers of metaphysics. They are at a different level, all right? Because I'm just giving you a description of how we can then, as ordinary Muslims, ordinary human beings, partake in this, at least the level of understanding flow, khushu, and, all right, preliminary baka, that preliminary fana, because I'm not saying, as I say, fana has many, many levels, but at least at a preliminary level, you can get the khushu and this sense of awareness of the grandeur of Allah, the love of Allah, the mercy of Allah, and you feel calm, you feel happy, you feel that there's no worries of the world, you feel your closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He shower you His grace, His love, His mercy all the time, that you then become a person who is not worried about this dunya. You become a person who is not fearful of this dunya. You only have only fear of Allah, but in your heart you have the fullness of remembrance of Allah and your sincerity in terms of your ibadah, to know that He is your ultimate goal. From Allah we come and unto Allah we shall return. So when you are able to do that, you will then sense a little bit of this sense of the joy of fana. I'm not saying, as I say, at a higher level, there is a lot of other discussion in terms of the study of metaphysics. Islamic universities and institutions then can study this in terms of how, within the framework of Ahli Sunnah wal Jama'ah, we can understand the state of flow, how this psychology, in terms of brain sciences and neurology today, can explain the state of khushu, and also can explain to a certain extent the state of fana and the state of baka in terms of the coherence of the spiritual realm, coherence of your emotional or your qalb, coherence of your mental realm, of your both the akal al-juzi and akal al-kulli, and coherence of a physical state, that you free yourself from stress, worry of this dunya, and you then track along a different consciousness in terms of your nature of being a Muslim, and your nature of your understanding of your role in this world as a true and sincere servant of Allah, all this striving to make ourselves good, helping others to be good, and making the world good, inshallah.